Thank you so much for having me here. What a great turnout. Thank you for taking the time to come to Capitol Hill, your busy lives, busy schedules, and mark this important occasion of the 80th anniversary of the repeal of the Chinese Exclusion Act. I see you have one of the posters of Frederick Douglass's Composite Nation. It's one of my favorite speeches. And Douglass, after being enslaved for 15 years, becomes free, and the first thing he does, one of his first major speeches, is to speak about America being a multiracial democracy and saying that we should not be excluding Chinese immigration. The Chinese immigration would add to the country. Of course, we did not take his advice, and in this country we passed the Chinese Exclusion Act, which unfortunately has led to a history of the exclusion of Asian Americans. We saw that in the internment of Japanese Americans. We saw that in Huggins' Thin case, where Indian Americans were not allowed to have citizenship. We saw that in the exclusion of immigration that was not fixed until the 1965 Immigration Act. We saw it after 9/11 with the profiling of South Asians. We saw it most recently with COVID, with the Asia, with the Chinese Americans being blamed for COVID. And we see it today with the Muslim Americans and Islamophobia and folks, people of anti-Semitism still with us in the United States. That is why it is so important for all of you to be here. To remind us that our work is not done in becoming a more perfect democracy. I will just say that my district is an incredible example of the Asian American community, Latino community, African American community, all working with the Caucasian community together to build the future that we want for our democracy. I represent the only Asian majority district in the continental United States. I'm very proud of it. And I don't think it is a coincidence that we have been a district that welcomes people from all over the world and also happens to be the district that has produced the world's most wealth in human history. $10 trillion, Apple, Google, Intel, Yahoo, Cisco, LinkedIn, Tesla, all in my district. And that is because we recognize that people from all different parts of the world, when they come to America, can contribute, that they are innovative, that they can help lead our country forward. So I just want to salute you for being here, for recognizing the work we need to continue to do to stand up for immigration and equal rights for all. And I hope that the next generation will vindicate Douglass's vision of really making it a composite nation. Thank you for having me. Thank you for being here.